One fine day when I was going to the school, there was an accident in between two trucks. More than 5 to 6 people on the spot were died. It was a big shocking moment for me because I realized, okay, these people are here. They are just lying on the floor. Nobody cares. If their family members will come to know, what will be their first reaction? And I imagine that if this would have been happened with my family, what will be the situation?
Cummins, a global leader in power solutions, has been a cornerstone of India's industrial landscape since its first manufacturing plant in Kothrud, Pune, in 1962. This iconic facility, often called the mother plant, laid the foundation for Cummins' extensive operations nationwide. Today, Cummins boasts a wide network of plants in India, supporting a diversified range of business operations, from power generation to engine manufacturing and emission solutions. But no matter how much they've grown, the Kothrud plant remains proud of Cummins' commitment to India's industrial and technological advancement, a legacy we all share and contribute to. At Cummins, safety is more than just a priority. It's a core value permeating every aspect of their operations. Across all their facilities, Cummins has implemented a comprehensive safety program that leaves no stone unturned and is designed to maintain the highest standards. Regular safety audits, continuous education, and awareness initiatives ensure that every employee, from the factory floor to the boardroom, understands and practices safe working habits. In May 2017, Cummins India welcomed a seasoned safety expert, Shyam Kapre. Shyam, a science graduate from Pune University with more than 19 years of industry experience, joined as the general manager of health, safety, and environment at their Kothrud plant. He brought a wealth of experience and a passion for fostering a safety culture. Over the next 5 years, his leadership would prove instrumental in elevating the safety standards at Cummins, ensuring that the Kothrud plant, and indeed all Cummins facilities in India, continue to operate with the highest levels of safety. For the last 2 years, as the Global Risk Improvement Manager, Shyam's influence extends beyond India, shaping safety practices across Cummins' global operations.
Saving people's lives, I think it's very much important for me. In 2017, I got opportunity to join Cummins as a HSC lead for Kothrud Indian plant. This is our mother plant, we can say, in India. And mix of the old infrastructure, new infrastructure. That was a new experience for me as an Indian manufacturing plant. First 3 months, I tried to understand what is Cummins itself. I first learned about the Cummins values, because Cummins trust on people, Cummins trust on leadership, Cummins trust on the ethical and integral behavior, caring of people for safety. It's not only safety is the list of the legal requirements. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, we are done. No. It's beyond compliance.
Cummins' core value is the caring culture. And here, we demonstrate that awareness and consideration for others. This is the applicable for employees, contractors, as well as visitors. So when anybody is visiting our plant, the person should go safely to his home.
Safety culture over here is that the prime most importance. We have created the culture in such a way that you have to be safe while working on the machine, while walking, while driving. So we focus on everything by educating, creating awareness. And we have created a culture through communication, through road shows, engaging employees in different awareness sessions. Even the PLT walks, we do take the leadership walks over here to see whether employees are complying with all the compliances or not. With that, there is an awareness level which has come in our employees. Even to this extent, I'll tell you, today even headphones are very common. In the entire premises, you will not find any employees using the headphone. It is for their safety.
And when I started, I tried to understand, okay, what is the cultural part, what is the process related part, and what is the overall real sustenance part of the sales. What I observed in last couple of months as a comments, then I presented my thought to the leadership. While I updated, I think management, they are having very different approach because they really want to, take the safety, environment and health to the next level at par. And I presented that we should focus some critical elements which are of safety, which are really life-threatening immediately. We cannot boil the ocean in one night. That was the motto.
One of the first significant initiatives that Shyam Kapre undertook at Cummins was to enhance machine safety across their facilities. At the Cuthred plant, a unique challenge presented itself, a mix of both old and new machines, each with its own set of safety requirements. With the full support of the management, Shyam and his dedicated team embarked on a mission to bring transformative changes to machine safety.
Availability of corporate guidelines, processes, and machine related requirements, we say the machine guarding minimum requirements. What can be differently we do? Because in any machine safety, what we say that nazar hati durghatna ghati.
Shyam understood that maintaining machine safety wasn't just about compliance. It was about sustaining a culture of vigilance. He emphasized the importance of daily preventive checks, ensuring that safety systems were always in top condition. You can't replace an eye for 10,000 rupees, Shyam would remind his team, stressing the irreplaceable value of human safety.
We cannot say that whatever we did is the best, no. So for machine safety, we thought, okay, how we can make a digitization? How we can make it foolproof situation?
Shyam and his team focused on taking machine safety to the next level. They introduced comprehensive guidelines for new machines, covering everything from design to installation. Additionally, they implemented machine safety risk assessments, involving external experts to educate the team on the latest technologies and international standards. Once Shyam had aligned his HSE team, he turned his attention to identifying the core people across departments, those with a genuine passion and interest in machine safety. From operators on the floor to supervisors overseeing operations, he sought out individuals who were committed to creating a safer workplace.
We identified the core people. Those are having passion. Those are having interest in the machine safety. And then we'd make a roadmap with the due approval of the management. Management was always available that, okay, for safety, there is no bar for limit for any resources available in terms of fund or in terms of the people. Then with the help of our maintenance team, we made our plan roadmap.
With these initiatives in place, the results were clear. Improved safety protocols, a more vigilant workforce, and significantly reduced risks across the plant. But for Shyam, this was only the beginning. The next challenge was even greater: how to sustain what they had accomplished.
People are very positive because cultural transformation we focus. Communicate voice, then it started building trust between them. And then we digitalized the process. We listed each and every machine safety device or guard of the machine. That is what I will say the very benchmark initiative we took for the machine safety.
To sustain safety across the plant, they implemented Maximo, an innovative system that recorded each machine with a unique ID and photo in an online database. Maxima auto-triggered monthly and quarterly audits, generating reports and actions if issues were found, ensuring every safety concern was promptly addressed and the plant operated smoothly and safely.
I think that mechanism worked, and I'm happy to inform you that this is the very innovative idea we did, which was appreciated everywhere, that this is the sustenance mechanism. I believe in sustenance because creating good is okay on times, but sustaining it for forever, it is very important. And I think this is what the revolution we brought in machine safety.
Shyam Kapre never stopped in his pursuit of innovation, which led to one of his most impactful achievements at Cummins, the implementation of the lockout-tagout, LOTO process. This critical safety procedure ensures that dangerous machines are fully shut off and cannot be restarted until maintenance or repairs are safely completed.
You know, in the manufacturing, production hours or productive hours are very, very much important. And for that, we should always upkeep the health of the machine. Unpredictable scenario of the machine will a life-threatening risk to the operator or employee who is working on the machine.
At Cummins, machine health is a top priority, supported by a robust system for predictive and preventive maintenance. Predictive maintenance involves daily checks by operators to catch issues early, while preventive maintenance follows a precise schedule every 3, 4, or 6 months based on manufacturer guidelines. Trained engineers meticulously adhere to these schedules, ensuring equipment stays in optimal condition and minimizing downtime.
Every machine is operated based on different types of energy sources, electrical, pneumatic, hydraulic, different types. There are multiple machines, they will have stored energies also. Kinetic energies are there. So when person is doing the maintenance, because lockout tagout come in picture here, because lockout tagout is nothing but meri life, meri haath mein.
At Cummins, processes and policies were already in place, but Shyam Kapre saw the need to make them clearer and more accessible. His mission was to reduce downtime, boost productivity, and develop a robust, easy-to-understand lockout-tagout LOTO process that everyone could confidently follow.
We started bringing the photographs of that particular person who is doing proper identification in terms of the different types of lock, because there are different departments that are applying the locks. Then we analyzed the overall scenarios and we identified some key focus areas. How can we further enhance the awareness and understanding about the LOTO in terms of the corporate requirement and guidelines? Second, we thought how in terms of the infrastructural, then we made a program, we should make this a benchmark process. And we, along with maintenance manager and I, we presented that in 2018.
Over the next 3 years, Shyam and his team built a benchmark process with strong support from management. They collaborated with departmental leaders, involving their teams in this journey of excellence. Training and workshops were conducted to ensure clarity and effective implementation. Placards with schematic drawings were installed near machines, helping engineers easily identify energy sources and enhance safety.
When there are the shift changes happening, so continuity locks is the concept. Guideline was there in a process, but how to make that if there is a changeover, long-term changeover, like second shift was there, and if night shift, nobody is there. Maintenance is continued. And somebody from first shift will come. How the key hand-holding will happen for the lock? That was the biggest challenge. To make it, where to keep key. Then if it is accessible, then that is not a compliance of the process requirement. It should not be accessible to the unauthorized person. That is a guideline.
The LOTO team introduced color-coded tags for different departments, with each tag visually enhanced to include the worker's photo ID and details. This simple yet powerful change allowed anyone on the shop floor to instantly verify if a trained individual placed a lock and if their training was up to date. Initially met with hesitation, these improvements soon instilled confidence across the team. People began actively contributing to the initiative, bringing new ideas and driving its success.
Started realizing that this is going well. How we can make it as a memorable spot for the people? Why can't we make LOTO gallery? And when I put in front of management, they said, yes, this is the fantastic idea.
To ensure everyone at the Kothrud plant understood the importance of LOTO, a comprehensive LOTO gallery was created. This hub offered hands-on simulations of LOTO procedures, including biometric systems. The initiative quickly gained attention, with leaders across India reaching out to learn more. Shyam and his team realized the gallery had become a vital tool, not just for training, but for showcasing their safety strategy to others.
We started presenting our LOTO. We started getting for LOTO different awards. In all India, more than 17 sites accepted our approach. They understood, and with some few modification, other things, they also implemented this. Then out of India, we started spreading this. Then China region, Europe region, North America region, some regions started approaching, because there is a global LOTO Council concept is there. And I was a part of that LOTO Council in that. We presented our KAP journey there. And then he spread them. And then in 2021, Global LOTO Council officially announced that Kothrud Indian plants LOTO process is a benchmark practice. They acknowledge, and I think that time, me and maintenance manager go back to our leaders and plants said, yes, this is what we make a benchmark within. And that was a very proud moment for us.
60 years old plant, and some legacy processes, as well as some challenges, infrastructure related, as well as some machines like old machines, new machines combination. All those challenges, actually, Shyam brought the solution for that. And that solution as under LOTO and APM, when this strategy was developed, our global HEC leader came here and recognized Shyam for this solution. And this is how Shyam is appointed globally as LOTO and APM expert under Center of Excellence.
Before Shyam, people used to think that safety is the safety department's job. With his coming, today every employee per se, every CWK knows that safety is my prime important job, and it is that I have to take care of myself and I have to take care of all others who are working with me. So his main contribution, I would say, that the OJT process, the LOTO implementation with the so old machines, studying those, and you know, it was very, very difficult. So he has really, you know, worked with multiple people to ensure that we have implemented that effectively. He came up with both the things together, the disciplinary matrix as well as the recognition program. So people know that if I violate, then it is not good for me. But at the same time, if I do a good job in safety, I will be recognized.
Safety begins with me, because when I will start caring me, I think automatically the overall safety scenario will change. I would like to give a message to people that start with me. That is very important. We have to always think safely, and I think culture will bring a part. And if I will always think, always HSC in me, I think that will trigger for changing the overall safety performance. That is what I feel.
Shyam Kapre's journey in safety is just beginning to take flight, poised to spread its impact across the globe. As the safety hero of Indian manufacturing, Shyam stands tall, at an inspiration, leading the way for others to follow in his footsteps, ensuring that safety remains at the forefront of every operation, everywhere.